Now, we come to this issue on the final exam pattern, which I think most of you will be certainly interested in. I think we have covered a lot of topics, and we have, I'm kind of going to go through the pattern here. So we have actually allotted about 8 marks. So the final exam, about 8 marks of questions in the general category of general project management, about 10 marks in the basics of critical path method, 10 marks in the cost time trade-off. Okay, and we have given you the breakup of these further below. Okay, the further below, the breakup of this, of the marks are there. So it gives you some idea of how to prepare for this final exam. And we certainly want you to do well in the final. I think many of you have been doing extremely well in the assignments. I think if you have worked through the assignments carefully by yourself, understood the concept, raised questions on the discussion, I think the final exam should be reasonably doable for everyone. Okay, we have resource allocation and leveling, again 7 marks for that. The presence diagramming method, we have given about 5 marks worth of problems for that. Monitoring and earned value, again about 5 marks. I would say it's tilted more towards earned value concepts in 5 marks, because that is from a computation point of view, that is very structured to do. In PERT, again we have got about 5 marks of what the basic concepts, as well as the calculations which we went through in PERT. So overall, this is the final exam pattern. If you have prepared well through the assignments and through the course, you should not have a problem. I would probably give you a hint in terms of saying that time cost trade-off, remember, it is quite an involved process. You have to be very meticulous to make sure you don't make any mistakes. So please do practice time cost trade-off meticulously, because there will be the questions on that can take time. Okay, so that's a clue for you to be able to do extremely well in the exam, because the time cost trade-off can be challenging if you don't practice how to do it properly. Now, with this, I would like to get into the acknowledgement part of this course. The people you see on the screen are the teaching assistants, without whom this course would not have been possible. And here we have Marimuthu, who's a doctoral research scholar. So he's been the anchor for this course. He's helped with all the editing, all the detailed checking, and several of your questions on the forum, as well as the quizzes, were taken care of by Marimuthu. And Marimuthu was ably supported by Madhumita. Madhumita took care of some modules of the course, as well as several issues in the discussion forum were answered by Madhumita. And here we have Purushottaman, Srinath. Srinath actually took care of several of the CPM based modules, as well as some of the discussions. And Thirumalai here, who took care of the initial part of the course, he took care of all the discussions, as well as the quizzes and the notes for the initial part of the course. So again, I would like to acknowledge this team. They were really instrumental in being able to float this course and being able to manage a lot of things in this 8 weeks of the class. I would also like to acknowledge the course participants. Okay, it's been really heartening for us to see the level of interaction in the discussions. Many of you have pointed out typographic or other calculation mistakes which have crept into some of our assignments, which we really thank you for making those calculations. It shows how meticulously some of you have worked on these problems, and it's really heartening to see that. Okay, so we feel rewarded when you actually are able to point out these things, which means what we are covering has actually making sense to you, and you are actually participating well in it. We have also got several requests for software to be covered. So I think I have responded to some of this, saying go to the to the internet and look at it, but many of you have got back and said no, the internet is not giving us what we want to learn. We would like it to come from Nptel. We would like to supplement this course with more software. We will try to put that up, but please realize software changes very frequently. And like I said, some of the professional forums are a better place to, once you become a professional, to adapt to the software, and which keeps changing. But we will certainly try our best, along with Nptel, to offer some sessions on the software. Might be in the next semester. Okay, we might offer a 10 lecture series on Microsoft Project might be in a few months. We'll have to put that together and allot time for it, but we're not making too many promises now, but we see that there is a demand for it. We'll see how we can address it best. Again, thanks to the course participants. Your feedback and participation has been really amazing. I would also like to thank the Nptel team, without whom this course would not have, you know, made it out of our PowerPoints and our you know, notes, because without the kind of platforms they set up, without the kind of coordination they have done, we would never have got it into this format. You know, every time we come to the studio, there are people to record and people to edit, and all of these have made this course possible. You know, they've had challenging schedules to work with us, and this has really, again, made this possible in this period of time. So again, acknowledgements to all the people who have supported us and made this course possible. And thank you, and all the best for the final exam.